Morning, guys. I'm Dave Canterbury with Self-Reliance Outfitters and the Pathfinder School. As you know, I'm a tool-heavy guy. I love tools when I'm working in the woods. I think that multiple tools and using the correct tool for the correct job is always going to be your best bet if you can plan for that. And one of the great tools that you can carry has always been the folding bucksaw, whether it's one that you make, like one we've got on the wall over here, up here, or whether it is one that you carry in with you. And when you carry a bucksaw in with you, you're really only talking about adding a minute amount of weight for what that tool will actually do for you as far as bucking down firewood and logs. So let's start off by talking about a couple of the common saws that are on the market today. And then I want to show you a brand new saw that's coming to market that's not available yet, but will be available on the Self-Reliance Outfitters website in very short order. And I'm really excited about it because of the weight and because of some of the improvements to the saw. So let's talk about that right now. Okay, so let's start off by kind of talking about one of the old bushcraft and canoe standards out there, which is the Bob Dustery folding saw. Nothing wrong with this saw. This saw is many, many years old and has seen lots and lots of use. One of the complaints I have about this saw that I've always had about it is it rattles a lot when you're walking around with it. And I'm not real fond of that rattling in my backpack or my pack basket when I'm walking through the woods. It's a folding design made from aluminum. It's a very simplistic design. It's made from square channel aluminum that folds back on itself to create the frame. And this is a U-channel, not a square channel, excuse me, a U-channel. And then you have a handle that folds and acts like a camming device so that you drop the front of the blade into a slot like this. The back of the blade then drops into a slot here, and the handle cams over the top this way to lock the saw in place. It's a very stable, very innovative, and awesome design that Bob Dustery had for a long, long period of time. Inherent problems that I have seen with this saw over time and use is, number one, the rattle. Number two, because the handle was made of wood, it could be damaged and it could also swell, and it needed to be cared for like any other wooden handled tool. So you need to make sure that you kept it oiled and things like that. You couldn't just throw this thing in the back of your four-wheeler or in your pack and just ignore it. There was some care that needed to be taken. And again, caring for tools is something that woodsmen are used to, so it's not that big of a deal. But there are improvements in this new saw and other saws that I want to talk to you about that kind of take care of some of those issues for people who are not so careful or not so caring with their equipment. But this Bob Dustery saw is probably the gold standard, I would say. At least it was up until recently in folding saws, and was for a long period of time. And then the blade just stored simply in the handle. You folded the handle over on top of the blade here, and it would lock into a hole at the top when you folded down the legs to keep it from coming out, but you still had that inherent rattle issue. Okay? So, but that saw could fit in lots and lots of pouches that would dampen some of that noise if you held it steady and things like that. So this was always one of my go-to saws. Now, beyond that, the Boreal 21 by Agawa Canyon, a company out of Canada. This is the saw that I've been kind of using all the time as my main saw. What are the drawbacks and what are the advantages of this saw compared to, let's say, the Bob Dustery? Well, first of all, it's heavier than the Bob Dustery because it's made from a heavier material. It's made from a heavier gauge material, and it is got a large plastic grip handle on it here, which gave you a better grip and a more comfortable grip that wasn't square when you were cutting with it for long periods of time. But it also had the advantage of having a plastic locking mechanism here that would never swell up and was a good solid lock. This saw has been my go-to saw for a long time, and we sell this saw on our website. The only disadvantage to this saw really is the fact that it's angled here instead of square, so you're limited on the amount of stroke you can make with this saw on larger diameter logs. Is that very limiting? Not really, especially in a bushcraft and camping environment where you're probably cutting 4 to 5 inch logs at max anyway. What I love about this saw is how easy the thing comes apart and goes together. It basically just folds over on itself very easily, drops down in, the handle folds over. The length is actually less than the Bob Duster overall, and that is not a function of the blade length in this case. It's a function of the way the handle folds over the top of the frame instead of sticking out of the frame. So you have a smaller footprint in your backpack or your pack basket with this saw. As far as going together, I don't think there's anything on the market, even today, that compares to how easy this saw is to put together or to take apart. This saw is probably, as far as an engineering, from an engineering standpoint, I would say that this thing wins the prize. And it does rattle a little bit if it's not secured in a case, because it's rattling here on the connection point. Doesn't rattle near as bad as this one, but it does have some rattle to it, okay? And again, if you've got it inside something, it doesn't make that much of a difference, but if you've got it laying in a pack basket and you're trying to hunt, stalk prey, and things like that, you want to eliminate any noise that you possibly can. Now, what I want to talk to you about today is a saw that's coming out on the market that's not out yet. It's a new saw by a company called Spring Creek Manufacturing. And this company is owned or partially owned by Tom Sega from Duluth Pack, longtime friend of mine, longtime supporter of mine. It comes in several different lengths, up to and including this big boy right here. It has the same tubular design or the same aluminum square frame design as the Bob Dusterud, except that the top here is an actual square instead of a U-channel like the rest of the saw, which gives it a little more strength in side-to-side movement or banging it around or beating it around in your gear. It has a very, very similar design to the Bob Dusterud saw, and that it opens up, drops out of the frame, comes out of the front, the legs fold over. So once you fold this frame over, you can put the blade in on either side because it has holes on both sides, just like the Bob Dusterud. You would slide the blade into the frame, into the square channel frame like this, roll this over onto the blade itself, and then lift up and lock it down exactly like the Bob Duster. The difference is the rattle's a little duller, but there's still rattle that takes place there, okay? So the main improvement to this saw, as opposed to the Bob Duster, is the fact that you have a plastic handle instead of wood. You don't have to worry about anything ever happening to this handle. It's a heavy ABS style plastic. And you have a tubular frame here on the top instead of an open channel U, you have a square. Excuse me if I said that wrong. It locks in here, comes up here, and locks in again on the other side. Sometimes I don't do things very good. Cams over, and there it is. A very stable saw. If you like the Bob Duster design saw, you're gonna love this saw. The Bob Duster design saws are getting very few and far between. This being very similar to the Bob Duster and a new manufacturer saw, they're going to be readily available and probably, I'm guessing, near the same price point. I don't even have pricing for this yet, wholesale or retail. I couldn't tell you what the MSRP is. I'm waiting on some information back from them now. These are basically production models from recent prototypes. All right? So these are production model saws, but they were recently prototyped and things like that. So they're not, I don't think, in full-blown manufacturing yet to where they can be sold to the public. As soon as they are, I'm sure that I'll have them on the Self-Reliance Outfitters website because we already carry a lot of Duluth products. And since this is the guy that runs this company, Grant, is Tom's son, I'm sure we're going to be carrying this saw as well. So a lot of people are going to ask me, I know in a video like this, what's your preference in saws? Okay. When it comes to saws, as long as you have a stable frame and a semi-comfortable or comfortable handle, it all comes down to the blade, all right? And you can replace any blade you want. My blade preference has always been and always will be Baco blades, and I like the dry wood blades because they cut green wood very well, but they cut dry wood very well too, and they don't have the tendency to jump, hop, and skip around when you're starting your kerf like the large rakers and gullets of a greenwood saw blade or a pruning blade do. However, this saw comes standard with a regular pruning blade, so you may want to think about that $10 upgrade of a Baco blade and keep this one as a spare. Very easy to change the blade. It's a bolt and washer situation on both sides. This saw, again, is almost exactly reminiscent of a Bob Duster, other than the fact that it has a square tubular upper instead of a U-channel like the legs. What I really, really like about this saw compared to, let's say, the Boreal 21, which is absolutely one of my favorite saws on the market today, is the weight. The weight differential is extreme here, probably almost half. If I had to guess without doing an actual weight, just holding it in my hand, this is probably close to half the weight of the Boreal 21. The footprint, again, is a little bit more. The same size blade, you've probably got 3 more inches of footprint up and down in your backpack or in a case than you do with the Boreal 21. But if you're looking for something that's lightweight, that's very stable, that's going to last for years and not have to worry about maintaining it so much because it doesn't have a wooden handle that's going to swell or crack if it's not well taken care of, this saw is probably for you. Again, it comes in several different sizes, so it can be adapted to anything from a basic pack saw all the way up to a full-on canoe or base camp saw very, very easily just by buying different sizes. All right, guys, I wanted to get that review out there today for you of the Spring Creek folding camp saw. Again, this saw is not available on the market yet. It is going to be very, very soon. These are samples that were sent to me by Spring Creek, by Tom and Grant Sega, so that I could test them and use them and obviously review them and get them out on social media for them. I think it is a great new saw on the market. I think it's going to fill a good niche. I think if it comes in at the price point right where the Bob Dustrud currently is, which is in limited availability, it's going to be a win-win for a lot of people because it will be less expensive than the Agawa Canyon. So if you're looking for a lesser expensive option or a lighter weight option than the Agawa Canyon, you'll be able to go with the Spring Creek folding camp saw. I appreciate your views. I appreciate your support. I thank you for everything you do for our school, for our family, for our business, for our sponsors, instructors, affiliates, and friends. I'll be back with another video as soon as I can, guys. Thanks.